It begins. I'm loading up the Dyco trailer, with materials, tools, camping gear, whatever I'm gonna need. Some of it I'll carry in the van for the Colorado trip. On the Colorado trip, I will be removing the tops of two different trailers in two different cities and replacing paneling. First one being a 59 Forester in Steamboat Springs, where I will remove the entire top, front and the rear, to replace some paneling and also to replace the rear sheet of metal outside skin, which I of course had made, and you saw that in the video just recently, at Hemet Valley RV, where they ship. And you know, I bet a lot of you people think that when I talk about Harbor Freight, Hemet Valley RV, Vintage Trailer Supply, other places like that, Good All Lumber, I'll bet you think that I get paid by these people. Nope, not a penny. And you notice that there's no advertising on any of my videos. I do that because I hate having to watch a video with advertising. I usually use the skip ad button, and then if there's a forced video, I don't watch the video at all. It just does not get watched by me. That a forced video is one where you have no choice. Usually within the first 5 seconds you can skip the ad, but if it's forced, I don't even watch the video. So you wonder how I make my money. Well, I don't make a lot restoring trailers, that's for sure. The Shasta I made $2,200 on, and it took a year and a half. And that doesn't include the gas, which I made probably 400 trips for parts. And I'm not exaggerating. So the way I make my money nowadays, because my trade has been taken over by illegal aliens a long time ago, and I struggled my way through that for many years and finally gave up. I was in construction all my life. So the way I make my money is through my website, donations. There's a button on my website, www.cannedhamtrailers.com. So if you feel like I've helped you in some way, saved you some money or some time, go there and make a donation. I'd really appreciate it. It helps me buy cameras, which this one's in need of being replaced again. These cheap $300 cameras are no good. I want a $1,000 camera. That's going to take a lot of donations, so please help out if you like my videos. And from now on, I'm not going to do any more complete restores. From now on, I will be zeroing in on specific jobs involved with restoring your trailer. Jobs that are peculiar to just about all vintage trailers. So it doesn't matter what kind you have. Anyway, yep, I'm packing. Right there, you're looking at over $600 worth of materials right there. That little stack. You got a 4-inch stack of birch paneling. That's $400. And then you've got $200 worth of pine and common wood. Common wood is more expensive because it doesn't bend as easily, and you know, with moisture and sun and heat and things like that. So there's $600 worth, and I've picked up everything else. I just have to load it. I've got $100 in putty tape alone. So anyway, we're gonna load up and I'm gonna get out of here in the next 2 days. We'll see you then. It begins. I'm packing up for the Colorado trip, where I'm going to be restoring, well, not restoring, I'm sorry, start over.